As time went by, the Venetian glassmakers became more and more ambitious and more daring. And at the end of the day, they were constructing elaborate goblets with, instead of a simple stem, the form of a winged dragon. And dragon stem goblets were sought after all over Europe.
A goblet can be made by making the parts separately and then joining the parts using bits of hot glass freshly gathered from the furnace. Here a dragon has been made, and a small bit of hot glass is added to its head. It's immediately lowered on to the bowl of the goblet, which sits on hold in an annealing oven. The annealing oven is used to keep the parts adequately hot, so that when they're reintroduced to the furnace, they don't crack. The glass is reheated to make sure everything is the same temperature. After another transfer to a punty, a little bit of glass is added to the bottom of the dragon and immediately used to attach the foot. It's then reintroduced to the furnace to make certain that all of the parts are adequately hot. These bits of glass used for joining parts are often called glue bits. This method of making goblets by assembling parts previously made has been used by Venetians since the Renaissance for making their very most complicated compound goblets.